Hi, I'm Sasha Petersa, and you're with PrettyLittleLiars.com.
Well, there's a little bit of a bang, which is another word for an explosion. So that's a little teaser.
It is Allie's first day back to school, so that's going to be kind of crazy for everybody. You know, we're trying to figure out if she's actually changed for the better and to see if she's still the same Allie. And obviously the group of girls that, you know, we've all kind of changed in our own right. So it's going to be really interesting for everybody else in the school, too, to see the new Allie.
It's very big. The title of the episode is Did You Miss Me Times 100? And so everything feels very big in the episode. We felt Pretty Little Liars, you got to go big or go home on the 100th episode. So we went very bold and big. And there are a lot of returns in that episode. A lot of people are coming back to Rosewood for that episode. And some people are returning to school for the first time.
It's all a tease. Everything's a tease. These girls have all been dead. You're going to find that out. It's all been a dream. No, I can't say that. But I will tease that Allison's returning to Rosewood High, and that alone is an explosive event.
It's a totally different dynamic, and you find out a lot more about Allison's family.
Well, Allison is back in Rosewood, and Mona is not happy about it, so you definitely will see some very interesting interactions between the two of them. Threatens the fact that Mona has now kind of turned herself into the next Allison, and Mona does not like that. So.
The 100th episode basically revolves around Allison coming back to school. So, you know, the first five episodes is really Allison incorporating herself back into society, if you will. But there's, I don't want to say unwelcome attention, but there is, from the kids at school. So that's pretty much all I can tease about that, but it's going to be interesting.
Well, the 100th episode of Pretty Little Liars is going to see Allie's return to Rosewood, really throwing everyone for a bit of a loop, trying to enter back into school and into the life that she knew. Too much has changed for everybody, so it's going to be very interesting to see how everyone has to adjust.
This season is all sort of about forgiveness for Arya and how much she's willing to forgive or not forgive certain individuals, and that includes Allison as well, because Allison's back and she's coming back to school, so yeah, we'll see. Arya? I mean, I think all of the girls are obviously relieved and happy that she's safe and that she's alive, but you know, they've grown. It's been 2 years. They've changed. They've evolved. And so to have this person back in their life, their ringleader, like, the dynamics are changing. And so I think certain individuals are happier than others. And it's just, it's a big adjustment. And I think everyone's just trying to find their place. And they're kind of, like, free-floating through space at this point. But hopefully they get their footing.
The 100th episode is really great because it's the episode in which Allison comes back to school. She's already come back to Rosewood at this point in the series. And it's about her reacclimation into the school environment and how all of the people that she was the queen of mean to are going to react to her now.
Well, I mean, I honestly do think that Allison has changed. To what degree, you'll have to wait and see. But I think it's mixed emotions for everyone in Ravenswood. Oh, shit. Excuse my language.
I think that definitely she might be a little bit more forgetful, or she might, you know, want to get back at a few people for what they've done to her, a little bit more revengeful, and it might, you know, inhibit her sight again. Who knows?
Gosh, it's a long list she's got to work through, which gives us so many episodes, you see? We can do 100 more because there's at least 99 more apologies. Allison owes apologies clearly to Jenna. Jenna's a big one on the list. Mona certainly as well, but Jenna is primary, simply because this whole situation of her leaving, what the girls have been through, so much stems from what could or could not have been an accident on July 4th, way back in the summer of 9th grade, when we were 10th. So Jenna's primary on the list.
The 100th episode, obviously it's a milestone just for, you know, the number itself, but I think for me personally, it's when Caleb first comes back to Rosewood, so that's pretty significant, and he kind of dives right back into the craziness that's going on. There's explosions and lots of drama, And, you know, I think he's interested to see that Allie's back, and he's getting caught up. He's definitely dealing with a lot of psychological issues and emotional issues. I think that he's trying to grasp what has happened. The very last episode of Ravenswood, you know, he basically helps to break this curse with the other kids in Ravenswood, and he never sees Miranda again.
The 100th episode, well, Caleb's back, so that's really fun. There's a lot of action. There's a lot of old characters that are brought back that you haven't seen for a bit. There's explosions. There's a lot of couples coming back together. And, yeah, it's a fun episode. We're kind of, like, in between two episodes right now, so I'm getting all of them mixed up, but the 100th is really good.
Well, I think had I known in season one what was going to be happening by the time we had 100 episodes, I would have said, we should move. Get out of Rosewood. A lot of bad things are going to happen.